Hello students, in this lesson we will know about our environment, and here in this video we are going to discuss about ozone depletion. So first of all we will know about ozone layer formation. The ozone layer is found in the upper part of the stratosphere. It protects the earth from the harmful UV rays of the sun. High energy UV rays breaks the bonds within the molecules such as DNA and proteins. Ozone is formed by the action of UV rays on oxygen molecule, and its thickness is measured in Dobson units, that is DU. The UV rays of shorter wavelength cause skin cancers, mutations in the cellular DNA, snow blindness, cataract, etc. Now we will see the ozone layer depletion. The ozone layer is getting depleted by the action of chlorofluorocarbons found in refrigerants and perfumes. The CFCs, that are chlorofluorocarbons, are acted upon by UV rays in the stratosphere, liberating the chlorine atoms, which acts as catalyst to degrade ozone into molecular oxygen. The ozone depletion is particularly greater in Antarctica, resulting in the formation of a large thin ozone layer, commonly known as ozone hole. To check this ozone depletion, Montreal Protocol was passed in 1987 to control the use of CFCs, or we can say chlorofluorocarbons, and other substances that cause ozone depletion. Now come to the ozone hole over Antarctica. Every year, ozone hole is formed over Antarctica during spring of southern hemisphere, that is from September to October. Ozone depleting substances, example chlorofluorocarbons, released by industrialized countries of Europe, North America, Russia and Japan, reach stratosphere, from where they are pushed towards poles by winds. During winter, there is no sunlight and temperature is very low, like 85 degrees centigrade. It favors formation of ice clouds. At this time, Antarctica air is completely isolated from the rest over the earth. It circulates over the polar region and is called polar vortex. Ice clouds provide catalytic surface where chlorine and other reactants of ODS can react with ozone and degrade it. However, sunlight is necessary for it. It is available during spring when ozone depletion occurs on a large scale. Ozone hole disappears during summer as warmth mixes up Antarctic air with air of other parts of the world. You can see here in this picture, here is the ozone hole showing in this picture on the stratosphere. So students, this is all about ozone layer formation and depletion.